Good morning, boys. In our yesterday's class, we started alkanes. So some of the preparations already we covered there. So some important concepts, stereochemistry also we covered there. That is in particularly, whenever cis compound is there during addition, if it is a syn addition, cis compound, CAR, please be conscious. Cis compound, anti-addition, racemic mixture. Cis compound, syn addition, meso compounds. Exactly opposite for trans compounds also. So by using that, we covered in our previous class, stereochemistry of alkenes addition reactions also, during the formation of alkanes. Okay? So already we completed, that is, how to prepare alkanes from alkynes also. Alkynes, from alkynes already we covered it. That is once again reduction and hydrogenation purpose. Okay. Now, some of the reactions of alkanes from alkenes also there, boys. So one is, that is hydroboration, and very, very, very important, boys. Hydroboration. What is this hydroboration? See here. So the reaction is alkene. When alkene reacts with the reagent, we know BH3, nothing but B2H6, boys. Diborane. So it is two times, but BH3 here involved any. So B2H6 break down into BH3 any. That is symmetric cleavage or RBH2. Or R2BH, at least one hydrogen is required, boys. So these are the reagents. Generally, I am taking BH3. Here, mechanism I will give with R2BH. I am giving mechanism with R2BH, boys. Okay. So BH3 also used. So in the solvent region, tetrahydrofuran. We know furan, boys, our organic aromatic compound, it is a furan end. So these two hydrogen, these two double bonds are hydrogenated end. It is called as a tetrahydrofuran. So what is the purpose of this tetrahydrofuran? Here we are using BH3 end. If no tetrahydrofuran is there, BH3 plus BH3 combination gives B2H6 end, dimerized end. So to prevent this reaction, this tetrahydrofuran is used as a solvent. Here BH3 we require for this reaction. Okay. So after that, a compound is formed. Something compound is formed. This compound is treated with acetic acid and finally gives alkene. Finally gives alkene. It is the preparation method. Alkene when reacts with borane compounds under tetrahydrofuran, first a compound is formed. That compound then treated with acetic acid that gives alkene. Let us take an example. Let us take an example. See here. This hydroboration is an example to syn addition, boys. Please keep in mind. Hydroboration is a syn addition. See here. Hydroboration, it is a syn addition. Example, CH3, CH double bond CH2, it is alkene. When it reacts with R2BH under tetrahydrofuran, so, and then continued with acetic acid. It is the second step that gives CH3, CH2, CH3, and alkane with same number of carbons. Alkanes with same number of carbons. Here, 3-carbon alkene is there. Here 3-carbon alkane. Number of carbons in alkene and alkane both are same, boys. So no reduction of alkanes. no reduction of carbons or no increase in carbon number. So same number of carbon atoms in the final compound, boys. So what is the mechanism involved here? See here, mechanism, boys. Please write along with me. Mechanism, done. See here. CH3, CH double bond CH2. Ra. First of all, R2BH. Ra. It is H. It is B R2. And okay. So see here, boys. This boron has empty orbital. This boron has empty orbital. Now this pi bond. This pi bond is migrated to here. Pi bond is migrated to this. So now this pi, this sigma bond is here. That gives a cyclic transition state. That is CH3, CH single bond. This is moved, boys. CH2, Br2. This bond is going to be weak. Here hydrogen. There is a new bond formation between hydrogen and carbon. And a new bond is also formed between carbon and boron. So this is cyclic transition state. It is the intermediate cyclic transition stage. Finally, we will get CH3, CH2. This hydrogen is bonded here. CH2, Br2. CH3, CH2, CH2, Br2, boys. So for our convenience, this is also note down alkyl group, boys. This is also alkyl group, C3H7. That is, I am treating like R dash. For our convenience, it is easy way. Okay, so that is, I am treating as R dash. So now that R dash, Br2. See here. R2 B with R dash. This R dash is that group end. R dash. Okay. So now this one is treated with acetic acid, boys. Second step. Up to this, this is the completion. Now under second step, CH3COOH. So CH3COOH, I am using any. So this is CH3COOH. CH3COOH, boys. Okay, so see here. This bond is migrated here. This bond is migrated here. This bond is migrated here. Slowly. That gives once again transition state. That is R2B. Slowly, this bond is going to be weakened. R dash. A bond is formed between hydrogen and that alkyl group. And this bond is going to be weakened. Okay, so here a new bond is developed. A new bond is, this is carbon. Here with oxygen, this pi bond is weakened. A new bond is formed between this boron and oxygen with CH3. This is also transition state, boys. Cyclic transition stage. After that, finally, we will get, so like this compound. This is slowly R dash with H. This bond is going to be strengthened. So that is R dash H, R dash H, okay, next, plus O, which is bonded with Br2, O bonded with Br2, single bond, C double bond O, CH3, boys, CH3. So this is our alkane end. What is that alkane? R dash means this one end. Where Br2 is there, where Br2 is there, so that is, this is nothing but CH3, CH2, CH3, and this is our alkene, boys. This is our alkene. It is the way to prepare. Alkene is converted into alkane with the help of borane end. So this is the way to explain how alkenes are converted into alkanes by using diborane or borane, not diborane, it is borane. So that's why this is called as hydroboration. Hydrogen is added. So that's why it is called as hydroboration reaction. This is hydroboration reaction. Very, very, very important, boys. Okay? So please copy that. boys, in this method methane cannot be prepared any. Note these points. Methane, CH4. Methane cannot be prepared by this method. Methane cannot be prepared by this method. Okay, let us take some examples, boys. Let us take some examples. CH2, double bond CH2. Okay, R2BH, tetrahydrofuran, the product is CH2, single bond CH2, here H, here BR2, here BR2, now it is treated with CH3COOH boys, that gives CH2 with H, CH2 also with HN. So this is the product end. This is the product. So this is ethane. Ethene is converted into ethane. Now the same compound I'm like using like this end. CH2 double bond CH. Boys, here only one hydrogen is used. There is only one alkene is involved in the reaction. But here I'm using RBH2. Here two hydrogens are there. Therefore two moles are involved in the reaction. Here one hydrogen is there. One mole involved in the reaction. For example, so BH3 is taken. So three hydrogens are there. Three moles of alkenes are involved in the reaction. Please keep in mind. Okay, so tetrahydrofuran is nothing but a solvent. Tetrahydrofuran is nothing but a solvent which is used to prevent dimerization of BH3. When BH3 is going to be dimer, that converts into B2H6, not involved in this reaction. That means that dimerization prevents this reaction. So to stop the dimerization, this tetrahydrofuran is used. That is the purpose of usage of this tetrahydrofuran. Okay. So next, this gives 2 moles CH3, CH2, BHN. That is nothing but twice here, CH3, CH2, thrice B is the product. Thrice B is the product. Here R, not C. Thrice B. Now it is converted into, treated with CH3COOH. That gives 2 moles CH3CH3NE. So this gives, this is treated with CH3COOH. That gives 3 moles CH3CH3. So product is same, but number of moles are different. Product is same, but number of moles are different. Very, very, very important. So triethyl borane, diethyl borane, diethyl alkyl borane. So these are the products, boys. Please keep in mind. So whether you are using R2BH or RBH2 or RBH3, if BH3 is there, 3 moles are involved in the reaction. That means a similar reaction takes place in 3 times and with 3 hydrogens. Okay, next. Next. So these are the important reactions, boys. These are the important reactions towards hydroboration. Now, let us take one more equation. Andy. See here. That is, for example, CH3, CH double bond CH2, boys. It is unsymmetrical alkene. When it reacts with D means deuterium, boys, R2, under tetrahydrofuran, BD R3, boys. Okay, so when this reaction takes place here, CH2. Here D, deuterium, boys. Here D, here BR2 is the product end. Reverse is not possible. And why not, sir? I will explain in alkenes end. CH, CH2, here D, here Br2. Not possible. This is the only possible way, Nick. So D at centralized carbon. So this one reacts with CH3COOH. Gives CH2H. That means, so acetic acid that gives one hydrogen, that is a terminal hydrogen. From BH3, the hydrogen is attached to middle carbon. Please keep in mind, by using this concept, I will explain different reactions. So this is not possible, boys. I will explain later in our alkenes. So during addition reactions, Markovnikov of addition, anti-Markovnikov additions are there. So I will explain at that time. Please, up to that, please keep this in mind. Please keep this in mind. So some examples, boys. Examples. What are those examples? See here. That is CH3, CH double bond CH2. So this one reacts with boron with hydrogen. So these are alkyl groups, boys. So any alkyl group is attached under tetrahydrofuran. Under tetrahydrofuran, the product is CH3, CH, here hydrogen, here CH2, B with, this is the product, boys. This is the product. Now, if this one reacts with CH3COOH, the answer is, here hydrogen is attached. The product is CH3 is the product. Next, if this one reacts with CH3COOD, now the product is, here D is substituted, boys. Please keep in mind. So where boron is there, that is replaced with hydrogen or deuterium, whatever it may be, that is from acetic acid. So this is the final reaction. Here bond is going to be break. There hydrogen or deuterium. So because it is hydrogen, here hydrogen is the product. Because it is deuterium, deuterium is the product. CH3, CH2, CH2D is the final answer. CH2D is the final answer. If it is treated with CH3COOT. Because it is T, the final answer is CH3, CH2, CH2T is the final answer. Please keep in mind. So where boron is there, that is replaced with the atom which is coming out from acetic acid. Okay? So maybe possible. Why not? These are all different technical reactions. So where hydrogen from acetic acid is attached, where hydrogen from borane is attached, that is already all totally explained with the help of mechanism. Okay, so that means deuterium, that is the central carbon, the deuterium, that means any group which is available from boron, which is attached to central carbon, any group which is available from acetic acid, which is attached to where boron is attached. Please keep in mind, by using that we will decide number of conditions. Next, for example, instead of acetic acid, I am using H2O2, boys, hydrogen peroxide. Oxygen is the atomic weight 18 and I am using that oxygen atomic weight 18 and so now here, instead of T, OH is coming out, boys. That is, the product is CH3 CH2 CH2 OH. Here oxygen has atomic weight 18 atomic weight. It is alcohol. It is the way to prepare alcohols from hydroboration reaction. If acetic acid is the reagent, alkane is the product. If hydrogen peroxide is the reagent, alcohol is the product. Same reaction, boys. Same reaction. Different reagents gives a different product. Hydroboration is useful to prepare alkanes, alcohols. At the same time, other higher alkanes. See here, I will explain. Next. Continuation. When this one reacts with AgNO3, when it reacts with AgNO3, that means this alkyl group and this alkyl group, two similar alkyl groups are going to be attached. That means the product is CH3, CH2, CH2, once again CH2, CH2, CH3. Higher alkane is the product end. Okay, next, when it reacts with last reaction, NH2SO3H. So boys, this is replaced with NH2 group end. That is, the final answer is CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2. These are all simultaneous parallel reactions with different reagents. So actually not used for preparation of alkanes, but some other reagents during diborate hydroboration may also use it here. Very, very, very important reaction. So that means if second reagent is changed, automatic product also changed. Acetic acid is there, automatically alkane is the product. Acetic acid. So amino compound is there, amine is the product. If H2O2 is used, so alcohol is the final product. AgNO3 is used, higher alkane. Two such alkyl groups are going to be attached, and higher alkanes is the product. So please keep all these values, all these conditions in your mind. These are very, very, very important. Very, very important. Okay. Next. So in all these cases, hydroboration reaction takes place. Where hydroboration takes place, where hydroboration not takes place, I will give an example. Note down a question, boys. Which of the following involved in reaction with? Note down the question. Which of the following involved in reaction? Involved in reaction with BH3. Which are the following involved in reaction with BH3? Very, very, very important voice. See here. Please keep in mind. Alkenes are involved in CH2, CH2. It is involved. Next. Alkynes are also involved in alkynes involved. Next. Alkyl halides are not involved. Alcohols not involved in this reaction. Ethers not involved in. Next. Benzene not involved in reaction with BH3, even though unsaturation is there. Next. Cyclic ether and epoxides not involved in this reaction. Next, RCH double bond O, aldehydes, it is aldehyde boys, RCR double bond O, these two are, one is aldehyde and another one is ketone, right? That is carbonyl compound standing. So involved in the reaction, aldehydes and ketones are involved in the reaction. Next, RCOOH and acids involved in the reaction. So that too, very fast reaction. Very fast reactions takes place. Next, acid halides not involved in the reaction. Next, anhydrides. This is anhydride involved in the reaction. Esters not involved in the reaction. Next, RCONH2. Boys, no information is available. No information from any books. So may or may not be, I don't know. Okay. So that means where BH3 involved in the reaction. So where unsaturation is available. So particularly alkenes, alkynes, and carbonyl compounds, acids. Acids, acid derivatives, particularly esters. That is anhydrides and anhydrides. How to decide? That was reactivity conditions, and depending on the situation, depending on the mechanisms. So these are decided, boys. These are decided. So these are all possibilities. These are all possibilities. So where reaction power takes place, where reaction not takes place. Okay. So among all these, among all these, the first reaction with mechanism, the first reaction with mechanism, and next, so CH3COOD, CH3COOH, CH3COOT. So some examples are given to you boys. All those are very, very, very important in this explanation. In our today's explanation, mechanism and some examples. Before this concept, some examples are given to you boys. All those are very, very important. Try to practice. First of all, practice all these reactions. Please try to keep all these reactions in your minds. So that is your choice. And you may go to by Harding condition, or you may continue with continuation written condition. That is practice condition. That is very, very, very important. This is about hydroboration. That is the preparation of alkanes from alkenes. So here, syn addition is takes place. Writing practice, that is the best one. Syn addition takes place. So in cyclo, that is in hydroboration, syn addition. That means both the groups attached are in the same side. Okay. Next subheading boys, next preparation from alkene, that is pericyclic reaction. Next one, from alkenes. So next preparation method, I don't know the number. So that is from alkenes, pericyclic reaction. From alkenes, pericyclic reaction. Very, very, very important reaction, boys. Here the reagent is, NaH double bond NaHn. NaH double bond NaHn. Okay? Either heating or sunlight is used. NaH double bond NaH. Okay? So now the reaction is, see here. CH2 double bond CH2. It is alkene. So NaH double bond NaHn. Double bond NaH. So either heated or sunlight is applied. See here, boys. This pi bond is migrated towards this one. So this sigma bond here and this sigma bond here and between these two. That means that gives CH2 single bond CH2. So here the bond is going to be break. Here a new bond is formed between carbon and hydrogen. Here bond is going to break between nitrogen and hydrogen. Here already double bond, a new bond is going to be formed. Next, this is nitrogen. So this is going to be break, and here is a bond formation. This is a cyclic transition state, boys. This is the cyclic transition state, boys. So this compound has aromatic nature. 1, 2, 3, 3 pi bonds, aromatic nature. So this compound has aromatic nature. That means its formation is very, very easy. At the same time, so this compound is, finally the product is CH2, single bond CH2. It is H, plus N triple bond N. It is nothing but N2 gas. That means here the byproduct is nitrogenic acid. Here it is nothing but CH3, alkene. Here alkene is converted into alkane through this reaction. Okay. So here the possibility is, sir, is this reaction possible or not possible? That means the driving force for this reaction towards product side is first one. Why, sir? Why this reaction takes place? So intermediate has aromatic nature. So that means it has something stability is there when compared to this one. That's why. So because of aromaticity, the reaction is possible. Next, at the same time, nitrogenous gas is evolved. So nitrogen gas is evolved means, so that is very, very stable. That's why this reaction is possible. So see here, the driving force. The driving force for this reaction is one aromatic nature. One is aromatic nature because the product are intermediate really. Intermediates. This intermediate has aromatic nature. Aromatic nature of intermediate. Second one, N2 gas formation. N2 gas formation, boys. Okay. So this is very, very, very important, boys. So this is cyclic reaction. It's called as a pericyclic condition. Pericyclic condition. This is pericyclic reaction. Note this point, boys. Note where this reaction is possible. So alkenes. With alkenes, this reaction is possible. With alkynes, this reaction is possible. Alkynes, this reaction is possible. All other cases, this reaction is not possible. That means acids, esters, amides, whatever it may be. Only alkenes and alkynes are involved in this reaction. That gives pericyclic condition. Okay. For example, see here, I'm using alkyne, CH triple bond CH. CH triple bond CH. So this one reacts with N double bond NH. H. So automatically CH2 double bond CH2 is the product plus N2 gas is the final answer. N2 gas. Okay. So alkene is the product. So this is also possible. That means alkynes also involved in reaction. Alkynes also involved. Sir, how this reagent is prepared? So its preparation is H2O2 when reacts with N2H4, this product is formed. H2O2 when reacts with N2H4. N2H4 is means hydrazinate. When hydrazine reacts with H2O2, this double bonded nitrogen compounds, that is azo component. This azo compound is formed. Azoine. Azinate. Okay. So now this azine involved in the reaction. Now this one also syn addition wise. That means all these reactions are syn addition. Hydrogenation, first I completed, boys. Their CAR, something are explained, boys. Hydrogenation, syn addition. Hydroboration, syn addition. Next, this pericyclization is also syn addition. All these are syn addition reactions. All these are syn addition reactions. See here. That is, for example, I am taking, this is the compound wise, already I explained, double bond, this alkene I named as A, this alkene I named as B. B is more reactive than A, boys, because here substitutions are very less, that's why less stable, more reactive. Here more substitution, this one is substitution, this one is substitution, this one is substitution. More substitutions, more stable, less reactive. Okay, so for this compound, I'm using first one hydrogenation, boys. Okay, so this is syn addition. So reaction, let it be taken as one reaction with one compound at where, either at A or B. That means at B only involved in the reaction. That means one equivalent hydrogen is given to you. One equivalent hydrogen is given to you. Only B is the reactant. Already completed at the time of hydrogenation. One equivalent. One equivalent hydrogen is there. B is involved in the reaction. Next, second one, hydroboration. Hydroboration. This is also CNH2. So HBr2. So at B only reaction takes place. At B only reaction takes place. Next, pericyclic reaction. N2H2ra, syn addition any. Here also at B is the reaction takes place twice. At B reaction takes place because B is more reactive than A. So this is about reaction preparation of alkanes from alkenes. Already alkanes I covered twice. Next preparation method, that is from decarboxylation. Very, very, very important. See here. Next submitting. From decarboxylation. That is from any salts of carboxylic acids. That is by decarboxylation. So from carboxylic acid we can prepare alkanes. The method used for this one is decarboxylation. It is the first method any. So please keep in mind. Okay. So carboxylic acids decarboxylated is first method any. A. So decarboxylation is the first method. What is decarboxylation? Boys, in our organic chemistry, wherever D term is used, D means removal. Carboxylation means carbon dioxide. That means decarboxylation means removal of CO2 from the substance. So from the given substance, CO2 is removed. The technique is called as decarboxylation technique. Okay, so this is very, very, very important. Next. Here carboxylic acids are used, boys. Here carboxylic acids are used, or salts of carboxylic acids are used. The reagent used for this process, is soda lime. The reagent is soda lime. What is soda lime? It is a mixture of NaOH plus CaOH. NaOH, CaOH. Actually, the reagent is NaOH, boys. So CaO also used. This CaO, what is the purpose of CaO? It keeps NaOH as dry end. So dry NaOH is used any. So always NaOH is going to be dry with the help of this CaO. So for dry condition. To maintain always dry condition for NaOH, CaO also used. That mixture is called as soda lime. So wherever soda lime is used, so CO2 gas is coming out. Okay, see here, what is the reaction here? That is reaction. That is RCOONa. It is the sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So to this, NaOH and CaO are used. Nothing but our soda lime. See here, boys. So this is coming out. That is Na2CO3. Na2CO3 plus R connected with H. So here RH plus Na2CO3 is the product. RH plus Na2CO3. See, boys, one carbon from your carboxylic acid escaped as CO2 gas. That means, so this alkane contains one carbon less than in
carboxylic acids. They are in carboxylic acids. That one carbon is escaped as the CO2 boys. That means, for example, if 3 carbon acid is taken, 2 carbon alkane is produced. 5 carbon acid is used, 4 carbon alkane is the productant. So see here, let us take an example. I'm taking CH3COONAN. It is a sodium acetate. Sodium acetate. I'm using NaOH plus CaO boys. That gives CH4 plus Na2CO3. Here, in this compound, 2 carbons are available. Here, only 1 carbon is present and 1 carbon is less. Boys, please keep in mind, this is methane. So it is the method used to prepare methane. That means by using this method, methane can also be prepared. Here, note down this point. Methane can also be prepared by this method. Methane can also be prepared by this method. Very, very, very important. Now, what is the mechanism of this reaction, sir? So, mechanism. What is the mechanism involved in this reaction? Okay. That means CH3COO minus ion, Na plus ion. It is a salt, boys. That first of all break down as CH3COO minus ion plus Na plus ion. Plus Na plus ion. Now, this CH3COO minus ion, okay, see here. This is here, this is here, boys. This is here, this is here. That gives CH3 with negative plus CO2 gas. Carbon ion is the intermediate, boys. Very, very, very. It is a reversible reaction. Carbon ion is the intermediate. Please keep in mind, in decarboxylation reaction, the reaction intermediate is carbon ion. Whenever carbon ion is there, go for carbon ion conditions, boys. So cyclization, something are possible. And all those reactions are also available. Already covered at the time of carbon ions. Cyclization, something else. All those are possible here. So if it is possible for cyclization, the cyclization automatically takes place. Okay, see here, some examples. So now this CH3. Now this CH3 I'm using here. Third step, CH3 minus and reacts with water. That gives CH4 plus OH minus. This is methane. That is the third step. That is methane. Okay. So this is the way to prepare alkanes from salt of carboxylic acids. Or carboxylic acids may also use. See here, for example, RCOOH is I'm taking. This is carboxylic acid. So no doubt NaOH is there, that is NaOH involved in the reaction, that gives RCOO minus ion, Na plus ion is formed, that is involved automatically in the reaction. That means either carboxylic acids or salts of carboxylic acids may involved in this reaction. That gives alkanes. Here the reaction intermediate is carbon ion. Let us take some examples. Some special cases. So I am explaining stereochemistry, boys. It is a pH, it is deuterium. It is a CH3, it is a COO minus ion, Na plus ion. Okay, that gives when it reacts with NaOH and CaO. Here, this group is eliminated and hydrogen is replaced, boys. That is respect to alkane. That means the product is pH CH3D. It is hydrogen, boys. Its mirror image also formed that gives HCH3PHD is also formed. These two compounds are possible. So that is enantiomeric mixture. Enantiomeric mixture. Both are possible. Both are possible. Okay. It is the first note point. Note point any? One. Note point one. Next, note point two. Note point two. Okay. So whenever a carbon ion is formed, because here reaction intermediate is carbon ion, if a leaving group is available, leaving group means is it ready to coming out as halogens, chlorine or bromine or iodine or tosyl group, OTS, it is called as tosyl group. Tosyl group, that means tosyl group means it is a C, yes, double bond O, benzene ring, CH3. This is tosyl group, boys. It is the best leaving group. Whenever a leaving group is attached at gamma position or something else, okay, so mostly at gamma position, so cyclization is possible. Cyclization is possible. Okay. So this is attached here. This is leaving. So cyclization is possible. So let us take an example. Let us take an example. See here. Just a minute. Example, huh? Example for this, see here. It is CO. Just a minute. CO, O minus Na plus, huh? O minus Na plus. So gamma delta at. Here I am taking chlorine. Here I am taking chlorine, boys. Okay. So C NaOH CaO mixture is there. So this is going out. This carbon gets negative charged. It is better only at gamma end, because this is carbon ion, alpha, beta, gamma. Okay, correct end. So this carbon gets negative charge, boys. This is chlorine. This is chlorine. Okay. So now this lone pair is going to like this, and this Cl minus is eliminated. That is, chlorine is best leaving group, boys. So now see here. So this is between these two a bond is formed. So this is Cl eliminated as Cl minus. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. Four member cyclic compound. It is nothing but cyclobutane with one alkyl group. Cyclobutane with one alkyl group. So alkyl cyclobutane, methyl cyclobutane. Okay, that like this cyclization is also possible at gamma position. At gamma position, a best leaving group. Leaving groups are nothing but these groups, boys. A best leaving group is available. Automatically, cyclization also possible. Cyclization also possible. Next, one more example. See here. This type of cyclization reaction is already explained at the time. Carbon ion conditioning. A carbon ion condition already I explained, boys. Okay. So for example, boys, see here. It is carbon ion.
third note, note this point, third note point. CH double bond O group is there. Automatically, this is migrated here, this is attached here, and so product is permanent, also possible wise. Also possible. Okay. Next. Fourth point. Here Cl. Here it is COOH. COOH. So either acid or salt of acid may be used. Okay. So this one treated with NaOH and CaO. This CO is coming out wise. This carbon gets negative charge. This carbon gets negative charge. Okay. So now it is eliminated and this is comes under like this. That gives alkene may also the product end. Alkene may also the product end. This is also happening. This is also happening. Next condition. When benzene is bonded with COOH, and a leaving group at beta position. See here. Yes. Okay. So NaOH is applied. NaOH, CaO are applied, boys. So now it becomes like this. So this one gets negative charge, and here halogen is, boys. Okay. After that, it is eliminated, and this is here. That is gives. Like this, like this. Then benzene is formed, boys. It is benzene. So this benzene is unstable, any aromatic compound. Benzene is unstable. That is rearranged to like this. See here. One more benzene. Like this, it is possible. Dimerization. Dimerization possible. At the same time, trimerization may also possible. And trimerization also possible, boys. Okay, so this is the name of this compound is triphenylene. The name of this compound is triphenylene. So these are all possible, boys. Whenever anion is formed, so that means anion is the reaction intermediate. So that means these are the side reactions may also involved. These are the side reactions also involved, boys. So boys, the most important condition is, sir, where decarboxylation takes place. Decarboxylation, the rate of decarboxylation is directly proportional to stability of carbanion. More stable carbanion is the product, so decarboxylation is ready to take place. And note down this point. Next. Next point. Rate of decarboxylation is directly proportional to stability of carbanion. Rate of decarboxylation is directly proportional to stability of carbanion. So these are all possible, boys. Direct reaction for main standing. These reactions are side reactions. These are applicable for advanced leverage. So that's why all we covered here. So some examples for this case. So that means rate of decarboxylation directly proportional to stability of carbanion. How to explain that? See here. That is, CH3COON error. I'm taking this is CH3 COON error.
Among these two, which one is ready to involve in decarboxylation? Try to identify, boys. A, B. Among these two compounds, which one ready to involve in carboxylation, decarboxylation? It is first butane. So among these two, which one is best? Next, second butane. That is COONa with NO2 group and COONa with CH3 group. So among these two, which one is ready to involve in decarboxylation? So it is one, it is two, and that means rate of decarboxylation is directly proportional to stability of carbon ion, we know. So here, that means CH3 minus is the intermediate. CH3 minus is the intermediate. It is a primary carbon ion, but it is CH3 minus, right? It is a tertiary carbon ion, boys. So it is less stable. This is more stable, and more stable. Therefore, this is involved in the decarboxylation readily. So similarly here also. Okay. So that means here carbon ion, electron withdrawing group. So, okay. Therefore, the answer is this one is more stable. Similar way. Okay. Next, some other cases. So other note points. First point, R C double bond O C H two C O O H boys. It is involved in heating minus CO2. This CO2 is going out, boys. That gives RCOCH3N. It is ketone. It is possible. It is also decarboxylation. So how is this possible, sir? See here. That is a mechanism there. Mechanism that is double bond O CH2 C double bond O OH. Okay, now this is here. Boys. Okay, that gives R C O H double bond. CH2 plus CO2. Boys, this is the carbon with OH and a double bond, right? It is enol format. It is tautomerized. So enol form is less stable and it converts into keto form. That gives R C double bond O C H three. It is keto format. So therefore, final answer is this one. So tautomerism is applicable. Next, some other cases. Second one. R. See here, it is alpha, beta, gamma. So between beta and gamma, there is a pi bond character. An unsaturation is there. Where, see here, boys. In your given compound, at beta and gamma positions, where unsaturation is available, this type of reactions are all possible. Please consider. So between beta and gamma position, if there is an unsaturation, either with oxygen, carbon, or something else with nitrogen, whatever it may be. So this type of reactions are possible. I am giving some more examples. See here. R. C double bond NaH, instead of oxygen there is nitrogen, so CH2COOH, boys, heating minus CO2. What is the product? See here, same CO2 is coming out, this hydrogen is attached here, that is R C double bond NaH CH3. Okay, next,
NO2 N double bond O boys, it is alpha, beta, gamma, and there also. Next here also. Oxygen CH2 COOH. It is alpha, beta, gamma. Unsaturation is there. Between beta and gamma, there is unsaturation. Our reaction automatically takes place. That gives heating minus CO2. That gives CO2 is going out. This is NO2, boys. It is CH3. It is CH3. Methyl nitrate. Nitromethane. Nitromethane is the reactant. Next. And most important. Most reactions. See here, most important reaction, right? That is R C H double bond C H C H two C O O H. So this is alpha, beta, gamma, boys. So NaOH and heating minus CO2, boys. Heating minus CO2. Now the product is R CH CH CH2, boys. Here double bond, it is CH2. As per our knowledge, it is alpha, it is beta, it is gamma. Okay. So this reaction is possible, and please keep in mind. So actually, in our previous cases, here we applied hydrogen rub, but here reverse case, because our cyclization reaction takes place. See here, what happened? What is the mechanism for this reaction? Mechanism for this reaction is R C H double bond C H C H two. Just a minute. R C H double bond C H C H two C O O H. This is our compound, boys. Okay. Now see here. This bond is migrated here. This bond is migrated here. This bond is migrated here. As per our knowledge, it is alpha, it is beta, it is gamma. Now observe the condition that gives R C H two single bond C H double bond C H two plus C O two. This is alpha, this is beta, this is gamma. What I write in previous case. Okay, did you catch the concept, boys? This is very 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 important, very 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 important. So wherever decarboxylation takes place, this is cyclization mechanism. Cyclic transition state is the final intermediate end. Cyclic transition state is the intermediate. Okay, so that is why. So this is very 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 important. Next one, that is bicyclic compound. I am taking C double bond O OH, boys. C double bond O OH. I am using here. This is alpha, beta, gamma unsaturation is there. This is alpha, beta, gamma unsaturation is there. Now what we expected? Delta minus CO2, minus CO2. So that is cyclization. That same theory. Okay. So this is here. This is here. This is here. That is like this. This is double bond. It is O H. Boys, is this reaction possible or not possible? Tell me. Is this product possible or not possible? Why not? Pashwan. Why not? Swaran. Yes, Bredig's rule. Good. So bridgehead carbon never goes to sp2 ending. Correct ending. That is, this product is not possible. So based on Bredig's rule. So you can identify everything wise. We know everything. That's why we completed GOCA. GOC gives all information about the organic compounds. Try to apply all those conditions wherever it is applicable in our synthesis, in our chemical reactions. So that's why we completed at first GOC. Later we are going to discuss some reactions. That is the preparation of alkenes, alkynes, whatever it may be. All these based on that GOCA. That's why you should remember, you should know each and every condition in GOCA. That is very, very important. If you learned, all these reactions are very easy. Whether it is possible or not possible. Okay. Next one. So this is about some of the reactions in decarboxylation. So in this case, methane can also be prepared in decarboxylation reactions. Methane can also be prepared, boys. So, but one carbon shortage is there. In final product, one carbon shortage is there. One with one carbon less, the final alkane is the product when compared to carboxylic acids. If carboxylic acid is having five carbons, our alkane has only four carbons. With one carbon shortage. Next one, from these carboxylic acids, second method is Kolb's electrolysis, and very, very, very important. Kolb's electrolysis. Second one ending, from carboxylic acids itself, that is Kolb's electrolysis ending. Okay, so Kolb's electrolysis, very, very, very important. Kolb's electrolysis. From carboxylic acids, next concept is Kolb's electrolysis. What is this Kolb's electrolysis? Here, boys, please keep in mind, radical mechanism takes place. Free radicals are the production. Electricity, whenever electricity is there, homolysis takes place. Am I correct? When we are using electricity, homolysis takes place. Correct or wrong? Help end, yes. He means electricity there. So homolysis takes place, radicals are the products. Wherever the radicals are there, radical mechanism takes place. Free radical mechanism. It is free radical mechanism. So Kolb's electrolysis, free radical mechanism, boys. Now, electrolysis means electrolyte is used, right? Electrolyte. That means through which electricity is passed. Aqueous sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acids. So that means either sodium acetate, potassium acetate, when they are dissolved in water, a solution is obtained, boys. Through that solution, we are going to pass electricity. That is why aqueous solution of sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acids are the electrolytes. What is electrolyte? Through which current is passed. Okay. Now I am using that one. See here. So exemplar reaction, RCOO minus ion, Na plus ion. It is, I am taking 2 moles, boys, RCOO minus ion, Na plus ion. It is a salt of sodium salt of carboxylic acid. This is dissolved in water, HOH, it is dissolved in water. So current is passed, electricity is passed. Now the products are, see here, this combination, one product end, R bonded with R plus CO2 going out. That means 2 CO2 plus this Na plus ion, this OH minus ion, this Na plus ion, this OH minus ion, 2 NaOH plus this hydrogen and this hydrogen, H2 is the product. These are the products, boys. So it is R bonded with R. It is nothing but alkane. Alkane, ra. It is alkane. Minimum 2 carbons are there. That means methane cannot be prepared by this method. Okay. Next, these two products are at anodes. These two products are at cathode. Okay, boys, once again, please listen. This is NaOH which is finally available in our solution. That means solution becomes basic end. Solution becomes basic end. So here, alkane contains at least 2 carbon atoms. Therefore, first condition, methane cannot be prepared by this method. Cannot be prepared by this method. Methane cannot be prepared by this method. Next point, because solution contains NaOH, so solution becomes basic in nature. Solution becomes basic in nature. Next, because it is basic in nature, pH of solution, increases. It is very, very, very important. So during electrolysis, these are the takes place. That is from this axis. From in this reaction, methane cannot be prepared. Solution becomes basic because NaOH is the product. Solution contains that NaOH. So that is strong basic. So automatically basic nature increased means pH also increased. pH of the solution also increased. Okay. So not only these products, boys, there are some byproducts also there. So see here. So byproducts. So that is, I'm writing like this. So R products are R bonded with R plus NaOH plus CO2 combination Na2CO3 plus H2 may also available. These byproducts are possible. This reaction also possible. So this is H. This is at anode. Now these are at anodes. It is at cathode. This is at cathode. These reactions, these products are also possible. Next, not only that, that is R with R, that is alkane, NaOH plus H2, that is regular combination. Along that, ester RCOOR plus alcohol plus RH plus alkenes. These are also possible. These are all side reactions. So these are side products. All these are side products. I will explain one by one, boys. Please wait. Okay. So this is general reaction. Now, what is the mechanism involved in this reaction? Mechanism of this reaction. So no doubt, we already, I told that the mechanism is a free radical mechanism. Free radical mechanism. Okay. So now what happened? See here.
How these compounds are formed? Let us observe one by one.
See here, boys.
In solution of in aqueous solution of RCOO minus Na plus.
See here, boys. RCOO minus Na plus, and it is dissolved in water, that gives RCOO minus ion and Na plus ion is coming out. Water is also there, boys. Water also dissociated as H plus ion and OH minus ion is available. Okay, so these two are anions. These two are anions. These two are cations. At anodes. At anodes, anions are available. What are those anions? RCOO minus ion and OH minus ion. Any among these two, this one has low discharge potential. This one has low discharge potential, or oxidation potential of RCOO minus is greater than that of OH minus. That is why RCOO minus ion only involved in the reaction, but not OH minus. So this concept I will explain at the time of electrochemistry, boys. So in our physical chemistry, electrochemistry, the concept I will explain, and not here. It is not possible here. Okay. So wherever oxygen at anode, more oxidation potential. At anode, more oxidation potential. Ion is ready to involve in the reaction. The ion with more oxidation potential is ready to involve in the reaction. Therefore, RCOO minus ion involved in the reaction. Next, at cathodes, what is that cathode? What are those ions available? H plus ion and Na plus ion are available. H plus and Na plus ions are possible. H plus and Na plus ions. Okay, here H plus ion has it. H plus ion. This ion has more discharge potential, less discharge potential, boys. The ion whose discharge potential is less is involved in the reaction. Or more reduction potential. So H plus has more reduction potential than Na plus ion. Therefore, H plus involved in the reaction. Therefore, at anode, RCOO minus ion involved. At cathode, H plus involved in the reaction. At cathode, H plus involved in the reaction. See here, the reactions are at anode, RCOO minus ion. Okay, through electricity, at anode, oxidation takes place. Oxidation means loss of electrons. So this one lost electron. When this one lost, that means oxidation takes place. At anode, oxidation takes place. That gives RCOO with unpaired electron is possible. RCOO with unpaired electron. Now, this bond, so half electron here, half electron here. That gives R with unpaired electron. CO2 gas is coming out. R with unpaired electron, CO2 gas is coming out. Okay. See here. Please keep in mind. Minus 2 electrons is not possible. Minus 2, if 2 electrons are lost, R, C double bond O, O plus ion is coming out, boys. So oxygen with positive charge is not accepted. That is why this reaction is not takes place. Only one electron is lost. That is why radical is formed. So free radical is the reaction intermediate. Here carbon free radical is the intermediate. So that carbon free radical, now it is first step ending.
at anodes. Step two, that formed alkyl radical once again react another alkyl radical that gives RRN. Or this alkyl radical reacts with this radical, boys, RCOO radical, that gives RCOORN. It is ester, what I told as byproductant. What I told as byproducts. Or R radical. So if it loses one electron, that gives R plus ion, boys. Losses one electron, R plus ion is formed. This R plus ion attacked by OH minus ion, available ending. OH minus ion. That gives alcohol is the byproductant. This is also happening, boys. So, but the major reaction, generally we consider this is the major reaction. It is alkane. Okay. Next, this is at anode. Now, at cathode. So, among these two ions, H plus ion is ready to involve in the reaction. So, two H plus ions, boys, here one electron is lost. That's why here reduction takes place. At cathode, reduction takes place. H plus ion takes one electron and converts into half H2 gas. Hydrogen gas may be released. Hydrogen gas. Okay. So, the unreacted Na plus ion, unreacted OH minus ion combination gives NaOH solution. Okay. So, side reaction. In solution, Na plus OH minus gives NaOH ending. That's why solution becomes basic end. Okay. So, like this, these are the products, boys. These are the products. Very, very, very important. Very, very. So, please note down all these reactions. Next, some byproducts I will explain it. See here, boys. Note point. That is first one. Boys, this method is suitable to prepare symmetric alkenes. That means even number of carbon. Because one carbon combination with one carbon gives finally two carbon component. If two carbon alkyl group is taken, four carbon component is possible. So it is, this method is suitable to prepare alkanes with even number of carbons. Please keep in mind, note down that. So this method is suitable to prepare alkanes with even number of carbon atoms. That is nothing but symmetric alkenes. Okay. So, for example, that means RCOO minus ion is involved. That gives R with R is the product and accepted end. For example, RCOO minus ion, R dash COO minus ion are involved in the reaction. That gives R with R, R dash with R dash, R with R dash. All these three variety of compounds are possible. That means mixture of carboxylic acid, salts of carboxylic acids are used. Different variety of mixture of alkanes are possible. Okay. That is why. So it is not pure ending. For example, I am taking this one as CH3. This one as C2H5. What are the products? So CH3 with CH3. Ethane, C2H5 with C2H5, butane,
CH3 with C2H5 propane ending. That means mixture of alkanes are the products. Mixture of alkanes are the products. So along these esters, alcohols, alkenes, esters, alcohols, alkenes. So mixture of alkanes. It is a mixture of alkanes and so or possible. That is why this method is not suitable. So by taking mixture of carboxylic acids, salts of mixture of carboxylic acids. So it is not possible, boys. It is not possible. Okay. Next. Note on this point. Second point. I am taking CH3, CH2, COO minus ion, Na plus ion. COO minus ion, Na plus ion. I am decarboxylating. That is, electrolysis takes place. Electrolysis takes place. That gives CH3, CH2 radical is the product. Radical. That radical involved in the reactions. So this radical. So combination of these two radicals gives CH2, CH3 is the product. It is one of the products. Two such type of radicals are involved. Next. This ion with this radical ending that gives CH3, CH2, COO, C2H5 is the ester. It is possible. Next. This with OH. CH3, CH2, OH is the product. Next. CH3 with CH3 also product. Next. CH2 double bond CH2 also product wise. So these are all possible. These are all possible. Sir, how is this possible? Let us take mechanism. I will explain with mechanism. Mechanism of this reaction. That is mechanism, boys. So this radical is coming out. So CH3, CH2 radical plus CH2, CH3 radical. That gives that is N-butane. That is the first product. Next, CH3, CH2 radical plus CH3. I'm taking like this. CH2 radical. Here homolysis takes place. This is enacted with this one. That gives CH3 with CH3 plus CH2 double bond CH2 is the product wise. So these are the two products. See here, these two are possible. This one I completed, boys. Okay. Next. See here, boys. Here, loss of hydrogen. Here, gain of hydrogen. Gain of hydrogen is nothing but reduction ending. Loss of hydrogen is oxidation. Same species involved in both oxidation and reduction. It is nothing but disproportionation ending. It is a disproportionation reaction, boys. Because same species involved in both oxidation and reduction. Same species involved in both oxidation and reduction. Therefore, it is considered as a disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation reaction. So, like this, reactions are possible. Like this, reactions are possible. Next. Next and important point. Boys, note down this point. Branching at alpha carbon increases yield of alkane decreases. As branching at alpha carbon increases, alkane yield is decreased. That is, percentage of alkane is decreased. Percentage of alkane is decreased, boys. That means, see here, RCH2COO minus
It is alpha carbon boys, only one alkyl group, RCRH CO minus ion, RCRR CO minus ion. From top to bottom at alpha carbon, branching increases, therefore formed alkane percentage decreased.
Formed alkane percentage decreased. That is very, very, very important. As branching increases, reaction speed decreases. So that alkane percentage decreases. Something going to alkenes and something some else end. I will explain at the time of alkenes what happened there. Okay, next point. And I am taking this compound wise. O minus K minus K plus ion, dicarboxylate ion, K plus ion. It is electrolyzed, boys. Electrolyzed. See here, this is going out. This is going out. So this carbon gets this carbon with radical, this carbon with radical. So see, just a minute. So this is with this radical. Okay. Cyclohexane is the fructane. Okay, cyclohexane is the productant. Very, very important. Next, in this reactions, in decarboxylation reaction, CC bond cleaved. Amma, idu koni. See here, this bond is going to be cleaved here, but this bond is going to bleed. That means CC bond cleaved. And see here, boys, between these two, a new bond is going to be developed. That means the CC new bond is formed. CC bond is, one bond is going to be break and new bond also formed. That means bond breaking and bond forming takes place. Homolysis reactions. Next and last, for example, if HCOONa, that is a sodium formate. If sodium formate is used, this is electrolyzed, boys. Electrolysis. So here takes place. This CO is going out. This hydrogen with another hydrogen is involved. Hydrogenic gas is produced. Hydrogenic gas is the product. So H2 plus CO2 plus NaOH are the products. H2 plus CO2 plus NaOH are the products, boys. So this is that is Kolb's electrolysis end. So for the preparation of alkanes. Okay. So tomorrow we will discuss some more preparation methods, boys. So some preparation methods, some physical properties. Tomorrow we will discuss it. Okay. Up to now. Thank you. Thank you very much.